Your moderator of today's event. Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. We welcome you all for a 5-day training program in 3D printing titled Dream It, Build It, organized by the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering and Department of Mechatronics Engineering. Our institution, Arupade Vidu Institute of Technology, VMRF deemed to be university, was established in the year 1998 and is located in Payyanur, Chennai. The institution is NAC accredited. Major programs are accredited by NBA. We encourage skill-based learning and research-based learning. We did not want to limit this to ourselves. And so we have organized this event to educate the school's completed students also. Through a great teamwork and effort, we have organized this event. Now, I invite Dr. L. Chitra, HOD Tripoli, who has put in a great effort and coordinated the things to make this day happen, to address the gathering.
Thank you, Jensi ma'am. So good morning to one and all present here. I would welcome Mr. Subramani from Proprietor Cornerstone. On behalf of our department and the management, I would like to have a very warm welcome to one and all present here for this skill development program on 3D printing. Actually, before starting this session and formal welcome, I would like to share two, three things about Cornerstone and Mr. Subramani. Since we have a good connect, because one of the best practice of our department is to have more good industry institute interaction. So we have plenty of industries connected to the institution and especially to the Department of Electrical and Mechatronics. And just I want to share you two, three important things which happened as a milestone in our department with the help of Cornerstone. As an activity, like you all know that everywhere we cannot get job, like the students after completing their degree, they may have a fear how to get their job in any, that is any different factories or any process industry or any EB related, if it is an electrical engineer or mechanical engineer, production engineer. So like that, they may have a dream. Similarly, some students have entrepreneurship skills, which they have to build their own company. So that is a good model, which we are supporting all the students with the help of more industries. And one of the important industry which we have a good connect for our students is Cornerstone. So as one of the member of our incubation center is nothing like we have a linkage of more than 15 industries, out of which the best is this Cornerstone. Because of them, our students are able to learn so many practical exposures, because not only theoretical exposure is enough for any student nowadays, since it is a very difficult task to move out after education. They should be very well expert in all the field of the real-time problem also. So this training we are able to give with the help of industries like Cornerstone. So some events, two, three events, I have to highlight you, because with the help of Cornerstone, we were able to build the products and they helped in making the students to excel in their field. One of our student, Ranjit, last year participated in IIT, the full cooperation made by Cornerstone, because you know that certain things can be done by students and certain hardware things and all the molding type, everything, making into a product, it is difficult for a student to do. Even though they have more idea, it may not be possible for them to make a product. So our ultimate aim is to have some interaction with the industries to build a product. So likewise, we were able to make some students like Ranjit, and you know, all these, we are suffering more than 2 years in this COVID pandemic, which we supported the government and certain hospitals with the making of a robo, which is going to help the doctors and nurses. You can see the picture which was made by our student along with Subramani. And this is the prototype first we made. And after some modifications, we went with a very typical model of a V2 buddy, that is a nursing robo. And it was well appreciated by the government, that is Pondicherry government and Indian government, sorry, Tamil Nadu government, because we also supplied this V2 buddy to Omantur, you know, that multi-specialty hospital in Chennai. So we also gave there, and some other products like AutoSan. You know that automatic sanitizer is present everywhere. So our students and Mr. Subramani were able to develop this product, and this was also being marketed with the help of Karnastool. And the other one is version 2 with voice enabled automatic sanitizer. So there are so many things like this, interesting things, and every year they help us to make in Excel certain competitions too. So this is the second time our student made contributed along with Karnastool, and they helped a lot in making the student learn new things in the field of robotics. Mostly we do everything in the field of robotics with Karnastool, and now we started doing like something in 3D printing also. So some other activities, so not only making products like field projects and training for the students, not only for our students, we are also making training for the students like you, like 12th standard, 11th standard students also, we are training. So last year we did how to make your own robo. It was a very interesting one, and so many students interacted in that. So the same we expect today also. So this event should be success if you people have good interaction with Mr. Subramani, because he is very kind enough to give clear picture about what is that. So many of you may not know what is 3D printing and what is the application at present now, and what is the trend happening in 3D printing. So only one request from my side to all the students, if it is a very interactive session, then really the session will be very much interesting for you, and he is very much exposed to you to in the practical experiences, not only theoretical. He will be briefing you about all the practical, how to make it. You can see the product at the end of our 5-day session. The 5th day, you will be able to see how the product was made with the help of a 3D printer. So really, it will be a very useful session. So I wish all the participants, and I congratulate all the participants to take the necessary inputs from Mr. Subramani. And at last also, that's the least, not the last. I would like to welcome all my dear young minds participated in this event. And once again, I would like to welcome Mr. Subramani, Karnastool proprietor, for rendering this much help for us, because nobody will help. In this pandemic, you know how it is difficult to help in online sessions. If it is a real-time training, it will be easy for them to do, but it is a very big task for them too, because they have to show each and everything to you through online. So make use of it, and I would like, I am eager to see the feedback from all the participants here. Thank you, 100%.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, I request Shah Rukh Khan, a final year mechatronics student, to give an overview about the 3D printing and its applications in various fields.
Shah Rukh. Ratan, Shah Rukh Khan is available inside the call.
Yes, ma'am. I'm trying to call him.
So why I have asked a student to give brief introduction, because you will be very much interested if one of the student who is able to explain. Shah Rukh Khan is a wonderful student for us, because he do so many activities on joining together with Karnastool. He is able to walk in two or three products along with the Karnastool. I am happy to ask him to share few things. That is just an introduction of, for some of you may not know what is 3D printing, just to show what is the application, in which field it is used, 3D printing. Just a glance only, 2-3 slides he will be sharing. Ma'am, is he available?
Yes, ma'am. We have muted everyone. He was not able to unmute himself. I have done, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Good morning, everyone. Myself, Shah Rukh from Finance and Supply Department. So what is 3D printing? 3D printing or additive manufacturing is a process of making three-dimensional solid object from a digital file. So why is this 3D printing also called additive manufacturing? The creation of a 3D printed object is achieved using additive process, where successive layers of materials are laid down in different shapes. So how does it work? A person creates a 3D image of an item using a CAD software program. The CAD information is sent to the printer. The printer forms the item by depositing the materials in layers, starting from the bottom layer onto a platform. In some cases, light or lasers are used to harden the material too. And there are three steps followed in this process. First one is modeling, second one is printing, and third one is finishing. Ma'am, next page, please. Use and now I'm explaining the uses of 3D printing. In what all fields this 3D printing is used? 3D printing is used in education, aerospace industries, medical field, and motor vehicles, etc. So what all materials are used in this 3D printing? ABS, very resistive to high temperature. And it is, this material is mechanically strong and it's a cheap material too. Second material is polyacidic material. This material print temperature is between 180 degree to 220 degree. This material price is moderate price point in market. And third material used is nylon. It's very strong and durable synthetic polymer. And this is flexible material too. Now I'm coming to the application of this 3D printing. First one is education. The benefits of 3D printing for education are, it helps students to prepare for their future by allowing students to create prototypes without the need for expensive tooling. Students learn about 3D printing application by designing and producing models they can actually hold. And a second one is prototyping and manufacturing. So 3D printing technology reduces the lead times required in traditional manufacturing, allowing a prototype to be fabricated in hours, not weeks, and at a fabrication of low cost. The automotive and aerospace industries are just two industries involved in manufacturing, taking advantages of advances in 3D printing technologies. And there are many other industries too. And third application is medicine. 3D printing application in medicine are used for producing metal orthopedic implants. Due to 3D printing capabilities for creating porous surface, these types of implants more easily integrate with the patient's own bones, allowing them to grow into the implant. Bioprinting allows for the 3D printing for artificial organs, helps solve organ failure issues in patients faster. So this 3D printing is becoming so like important in many fields, especially in medicinal areas. There are many applications in just in medical field alone. Now, fourth application is construction. Ma'am, next page, please. Constructing 3D printing offers various technology that use 3D printing as the main way of fabricating buildings or construction components. 3D printing applications that are used in construction include extrusion, powder bonding, and additive welding. And fifth application is art and jewelry. 3D printers allow jewelry makers to experiment with designs not possible with traditional jewelry making methods. So these are top five applications of 3D printing. There are many other applications too. So this 3D printing technology is becoming like in this developing world, in this technologically developing world, 3D printing is becoming more important and a futuristic technology. This 3D printing technology could revolutionize and reshape the world. Thank you, ma'am. That's all.
Thank you, Shahrukh. That was a very wonderful presentation indeed. Now, I take the opportunity to introduce the resource person of the day, Mr. S. Subramani. Mr. S. Subramani is an electronics and communication engineer. He is the founder and CTO of Cornerstone. It is a robotics and automations-based company. And he worked as a junior research scientist under the DST-funded project for 3 years. He has a very rich experience in the field of automation and robotics. and has executed various projects across India. He has led many projects with his excellent managerial skills, and he is a very good team player. His key skills include the developing of robots, creating automation in automobiles, homes, electronic locker security systems. Some of the projects that he has executed, to name a few, are V2 Buddy, the nursing robot, Petra wheelchair, safety system for aerial work plantation, platform cranes, solar powered vehicles, electric cars, car body designing, robotic cars, and voice control car, and so on. So it is a pleasure to have you, sir.
Thank
the
you,
session ma'am. Is over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Jensi, ma'am. Thank you, Chitra, ma'am, and thank you, Sharu, for this opportunity given by AVIT College. Now, students, all are there, right? We can move into the session. This session, we want you guys to be interactive. We want you guys to be interactive, and we'll let this session. 1 minute. Sorry guys, sorry for the interruption. This session is all about 3D printing and introduction and the types of 3D printing we are about to see now. And I want you guys to be very much interactive with us, with me, so that we can learn a lot of things about 3D printing, what is 3D printing, and all Sharath Khan has explained. But in depth, what is 3D printing and what are its application and all, we'll see by examples. So I need you guys to be interactive with me. Any one or two members also can interact, and you can ask some doubts. I want this session to be very much interactive so that we can learn a lot. Okay, students, are you ready for we'll go to? Shall we go to this session?
Sir, actually, they cannot unmute, and you want me to change the settings and...
Yes, sir. They want. I want them to interact also. So
okay, then I change the settings.
Yes.
You can unmute now and talk if you want. Okay.
Sir, have you unmuted, sir, all the people?
No. I have changed the settings. They okay. can unmute themselves and they can talk if they want.
Sure. Thank you, sir. Guys, are you there? See, now we are coming to the topic called 3D printing. What is 3D printing? Can anyone guess what is the 3D printing and why it is needed for in our day-to-day life or in the engineering field? Can you understand why we need 3D printers to build objects and all? Anyone? Can anyone see 3D printing is nothing but three-dimensional printing. Okay, the object, we can build objects like this also. We can do a miniature, we can do some toy-like structure, or you can do yourself. You can scan your image and scan your thing, and you can create on a 3D printed object, or you can do an engineering part. Okay, we can do engineering parts like this to be enabled for working and all. There is other types of printing also available. This kind of printing and all, it's called a miniature printing, and this is a 3D printed engineering product. Okay, there are many applications for 3D printing. We are going to print the objects in three-dimensional. Using 3D printers, we can build objects what you think in your mind. which is very much complicated, which is very much complicated. If you go for a plastic dial, it will be costing you around 50,000 to 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs, it will be costing you. But if you are going to print it in 3D printers, it will be costing you in thousands only. It will be very much cost effective for you guys to make the product, make the one which you think it will be correct. You can explore a lot of things using 3D printers, and you can print n number of things. You can not only in this 3D printer is not only given to the engineering field. It is also associated for gifting field, the stationary items, the engineering items. As Shahrukh Khan explained, they have built houses, okay, in China and in India also. IIT people, IIT Madras, one incubated company, has built houses, real-time houses in Chennai and in China. Okay, they have built and cost-effective houses for the people using 3D printers. It's a very large 3D printer like structure which has built like this. Okay, they can build houses with n number of combinations. We will understand first what are 3D printers and how it will be, how it look like. Okay, I'll show you the 3D printer which currently I have. Okay, I want you people to interact with me also so that we can do the things right. Can you all see? Can you all see the 3D printer right here?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes. This, I mean, one object has been printed and it has been extruded. Okay. It's ready to be taken out and
for. Ramani, sir, excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
இது மெயின் இதுக்கு காமிக்க முடியுமா இங்க ஸ்லைடர் வர்ற இடத்துல
என்னம்மா
இப்போ ஸ்லைடர் ஷேர் பண்ணிட்டேன்
ஓகே 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 ஒன் மினிட் ஒன் ஆ Can you all see? Can you all see the 3D printer in your large
screen? Sir, if they pin the screen they can see, sir. You people can pin your screen with okay. Subramani sir's screen, you will be able to see the video in full screen.
Can you all see, guys?
Yes,
because
sir.
After you yes, realize sir. What yes, is a 3D printer and how it is done, then only you can imagine whatever I say. Okay, then only you can understand what I'm saying, it's right, or how it will be operating and all. If you guys have seen this printer and know how it works, then only you can imagine what I am saying and all. You can see here the bed, it will be moving. Can you all see? I am moving with my hands.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This will be moved by the motor, stepper motor, which is inside this. Okay. You can see the black color structure right here. The black color structure right here, it's a motor. Okay, then you have one top angle also moving. See here, this is also moving. This is also one moving part. Okay, you have two motions right now available. Can you all guess what are the motions you are available? How many motions are available?
Two types.
Two motions are available. Okay, one is X direction and one is Y direction, it's moving. Okay, but imagine for three dimension, how what will be there?
Yes, settings for Matthew.
For three dimension. What?
XYZ.
Yes, for three dimension, it will be XYZ action. But here I showed you only X and Y direction, not the Z direction. Okay. Can you understand?
Yes,
guys,
sir.
Yes.
Hippo, what you have shown, only the X direction and the Y direction. What about the Z direction? How it operates? How you can... what, ma?
By adding legs.
Upward and downward. Upward and downward direction, sir.
Yes. But you have to imagine that only two directions we are moving, but how we are going to print in three dimension. For that, X direction means it will be moving in the this direction, okay, in this direction. Y direction, in this direction it will be moving. Z direction, it will be on another axis. But for the objects to be printed in three dimensions, for the third dimension, both x axis and y axis has to be moved at the same point. Okay, simultaneously it will be moving. Both the axes will be moving like this to put a round or a drawn object round like structure. Okay, can you imagine? Both the objects are moving, both the motions are moving to in order to create the third dimension. Okay, can you understand, guys?
Sir.
If not understand means I can explain you one more time also. You can ask me doubts. If there, sir, if there is a, yes ma, tell ma.
Sir, one more thing.
Yes, tell.
And that like how that third axis, Z axis, that moment combination of X and Y.
Yes, both the axes will be operating at the same time in order to give the third dimension. Okay, if you want to change the layer height, means it will be moving like this, la. Y direction will be there. It will be going up and going down. Okay, this direction will be moved in the both the axes will be moving for to put on round circle, because both are straight motion, right? I showed you what is the motion available here. Okay, both are straight motion. Two motors are there separately for height adjustment. Okay, wow. For height adjustment, there are two motions. For putting a circle, these two motions has to be operated at the same time. Then only you can do stuffs. Okay, do the objects in three dimension. There are many types of printers. This is one of the type. Okay, this is one of the type of printer which currently we are having, but there are n number of types available, readily available in the market. Okay, n number of types readily available in the market, which we'll explore as days go by, as our classes go by. Now the agenda of this class is we are going to build one engineering part. Okay, what we are going to build, one engineering part, that is for humanoid robot. We are going to set up servo motors. Have you seen servo motors, ma? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
I'll show you for those who haven't seen a type of servo motors and all. Okay.
Subramani, sir, please show that first that statue you were showing, no, sir. Now you show.
Yes, yes. Can you see the statues which we have made using 3D printers? From leg, from head to toe, we have just printed, and hand painted this one. We have hand painted this one. Okay, there are many other statues also which we have made and given to the customers. Can you all see the statues?
Yes, sir.
For this, there will be. I'll show how it will be printing and all as things go by. If you want to see the inside, how it looks like, la, I'll show you how will the cross section of this inside. It will be having some rigid structures. Yes, ma'am.
Number come on.
Hello.
Number come on.
Participants, unmute. Sorry, mute if you are not asking any questions.
See, here we have internal structures. Which you are currently seeing in this thing. This is half printed. This is a cross section of the particle which we have been printing. The inside structure will be rigid type structures. This also needs lot of engineering skills. And you imagine that only rigid parts can be done with this, but they can be in single print without adding some parts. You can do structures like this also, the movement structures. This will be very much helpful. The flexible items and the joint and all, you can itself design in the 3D printer itself. we haven't done anything after, we haven't joined the slings and all. This is ready-made printed in single print. It has come as an output. Okay, the movement joints and all, you can see la, the joints. It has printed by itself. We have joints here. All the parts we have been moving here. Okay. Can you all see this? You can use it like a keychain. You can print yourself. You can print your face itself here. And you can utilize in for n number of things, like gift items or any engineering part, you can print like this. And you can add motors for that. Can you understand that? You can use your face like keychain like structure. There's a keychain like structure which you have made. You can put holes and you can use it as a keychain. It's a human structure which one customer has been ordered and we have made this. Okay. Like this human body also we can make. You can in using 3D printers. There are n number of opportunities available using 3D printers. It's not the thing only engineering parts can be done. Only an engineering part can be done using 3D printer. But it can be used for n number of applications. That can be building a house, or you can build engineering parts, or you can build ornaments, the necklace, or any jewelry items. You can using 3D printers. This is a servo motor. This motor can be used to ping with this. Okay, this motor can be mounted with this thing, and you can move this item. This is a humanoid part which we will also print as the days go by. We'll print one by one, and we have already printed some items. And at the last day, we can do the assembling also. We'll see the assembling part, and the next day, tomorrow, we'll see how the things are being scanned. We are having a scanner, 3D scanner, which is used to scan the human structure. You can scan your face, you can scan your whole body, and whatever the engineering parts available, you can scan an object. There are n number of 3D scanners also available in the market, which you can purchase as your need, as you have the need. According to your application, you can purchase a particular type of scanner. And this is available in the market, and you can do a number of stuffs with that. Can you all understand? Any doubts with this?
No, sir.
No doubts. Okay. Okay. Little bit we can learn about what is 3D printer and all. We have been gone through in the internet also. But little stuffs, the things to be known for having a 3D printer and all, we will discuss right now. Okay, I'll share my screen, my PPT, and you can learn a bit. Can you all see? Can you all
yes,
see
sir.
My screen?
Yes, sir.
This is a starting slide. Okay, then we are going for types. There are n number of types, ma. There are mainly, we are about seeing 7 types. We not only use plastics for printing, we can print metal also. Can you understand? Can you all understand? This is not
yes, sir.
About printing only plastic. We can use 3D printers to print this thing also, the metal items also. Okay, plastic means what? Some will be thinking that it will be printing only plastic. But we can print metal also using this. Okay, we'll show what and all the types of 3D printers are right now available. And the technologies, there is only 3 technologies, Ma, used for 3D printing. Only 3 technologies are available right now in the market. Okay, we can see what and all the technologies used by the 3D printers, and using that how they are printing and all. Okay, first man to know about 3D printing is Charles W. Hull. Okay, this was the person in 1980s. He was the one who built the first 3D printer. You can Google it, and you can search that. You can know he was the person who first done one 3D printer and printed some object. Can you all see him in the image?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you all see the PPT?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This has been patented. Every engineering item or any unique idea will be patented, right? Right or wrong? You know what is patent? Patent, copyrights. For engineering people, whenever things you do something unique or you innovate something, invent something, they will be having a copyrights. There are copyrights things which we have to apply for it. That is called IP rights. Okay, intellectual property. That is named intellectual property. It's called. Then this person has invented, but the patent is in hold of Xerox, the company called Xerox. Okay, name the company. Which company has hold the patent for 3D printers?
Xerox.
Yes, Xerox is the company which holds the patent for 3D printers. But you can notice, still 2009 la, many haven't come across 3D printers. We don't come many about 3D printers. 3D printers are available from 1980s, but our people, we are still new to 3D printers. This is why means the cost of the 3D printers were very much higher because of this patent. Okay, but from 2009, they have cancelled the patent. That is, the patent period has been over. Okay, then only the 3D printers have come to us for at an affordable price. Okay, can you all understand why just now after so many years, 3 decades or 4 decades, now only 3D printers are getting famous? Why means for still now, still 2009 period, it was under patented thing. So the price of the 3D printers were quite high. Okay, it was not affordable, but now it is a free source like thing. Patent has been got over, and we are getting 3D printers at an affordable price. Can you understand? Then
yes, sir.
Yes. Can you guess what is STL? Some STL I have written in the PPT, la. STL. Some STL I have written, la. Every printing or everything, every engineering part diagram will be having an extension file format. You have photo in the file format of JPEG, right? JPG, you have come across the photos. All will be familiar with the photos. So I am telling with the photos. JPEG, it will be there. And for videos, MP4 video is there. Extension will be there, no? The format. Dot wave format is there.
Yes, and
likewise, engineering diagrams along WG, DWG is there, and CorelDRAW file is there. And for Word document, we have a docs, dot docs, it will be there. For PPT, it will be very different extension. Likewise, the printer, the software, the object, the diagram file is named like STL file. The STL files is nothing but standard template library. Okay, this comes under the C++ programming language. Okay, C++ programming language. So it's called standard template library. Can you all understand what is that STL means?
Standard template library.
Yes, standard template library. You all clear with what and all we have to know? Okay, things to know, we have been clear, right? We can go for the technologies involved. The next slide. Okay, before that, any doubts means you can ask. Any doubts or any bulb is glowing on your head means you can ask me. No bulbs are glowing in your head using application and all. Any doubts still now? Shall we move into the technologies? we have to know this technology so that we can understand 3D printing quite a bit more in depth, so that you can learn so much of things and you can understand the concept of 3D printer. So only we are getting some lighter versions of theories, okay, nothing very much depth inside and all. Okay, we will be going inside the technologies. Can you understand? Can you see 3D printing technologies? Okay, there are three main technologies used in what 3D printing. One is called sintering, another is called melting, and another is called stereolithography. Can you understand?
Yes, sir.
Sintering, yes. Melting, and stereolithography. These are the three technologies. If you go inside this three technologies, is a very vast thing to be known. Okay, sintering means heating the material. Okay, heating the material, but not to the melting point. Okay, heating to a particular temperature where it can be folded or it can be handled. You can see like the metal parts and all, they will be heating some metal parts and they will be bending like this. Can you imagine? Straight rod will be there, straight rod will be there, and they will be melting in this part and they will be bending this. Okay, it won't melt, but it can give shapes. We can do anything which we want to do in the sintering process. I'm giving a glimpse, only the glimpse. I'm not going very much in depth so that it will be very much confusing without seeing it in straight eyes. Without seeing in your eyes, it will be very much confusing, and I don't want you guys to be confused. I'm giving very basic explanation. Okay, wow. Is it okay for you?
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sintering means what? Heating the material, but not to the melting point. It won't, we must not allow the material to melt, but it can be handled. We can bend the equipment. We can imagine a rod is being heated and we can bend the rod. After heating only, they can bend the rod and all. Likewise, we are going to heat the material and give some shape for that. This is one technology of 3D printing. The next one is melting. Melting means you'll be having some filament. Can you understand? You'll be having what? Some
filament.
A wire-like structure. I'll show you, right? Can you all see?
Yes, sir.
Can you all see the wire-like structure? This is a filament. This is PLA, they'll be saying. There are n number of filaments available in the market. You can use ABS filament, you can use TPU filament, you can use nylon, you can use some other things also in a mixture like thing. But the most common 3D printers, they'll be using PLA. This is a cost effective one and easily available one in the market all over the world. Most of the 3D printers will be using PLA. Next to that, they will be using ABS. Okay, there are other kinds of filaments also. This filament, while heating, it will be melting like this. It will melt and it will be given to the nozzle. You can see in the this thing, I'll show in the camera so that you can understand better. Okay. Can you see the filament has come here? Can you see here?
Yes, sir.
The filament has been from there. I have feeded into the extruder. Okay, there is one motor here, the black color structure, which will make the feeder to go. Okay, it will feed the filament. At the end, you can see at the nozzle.
Hello, sir.
This is a nozzle, right?
Subramani, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, presentation has stopped.
Yes. One minute. Sorry. Thank you, sir. Can you all see the filament? Okay, filament is fed into the extruder. Okay, at the end, at the back, at the down, we can see the nozzle. You can see the nozzle right here.
Yes,
can
sir.
You see?
Yes, sir.
Can you see the nozzle?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is a nozzle. You can see that filament is coming out here. Can you see a layer? Can you see that?
Yes, yes.
The white
yes,
color filament is being extruded. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thus, nozzle gets heated up. That's the thing which gets heated up. Okay. It will be getting heated and it will melt the filament. And it will do the stuff like this, the structure. Whatever structure you give in the program, it will be done like this. Okay. It will be moving to and fro and forward and reverse motion, and it will make the printing to happen. Okay, this is called melting technology. This is one of the technology which is being currently used. Can you understand? This is one of the technology. These are called FDM printers. What name it?
FDM.
FDM printers. FDM printers means fused deposit printers. Okay. FDM means fused deposit machines. Right. This will be melting it and it will be deposited at the bed. We will be calling the moving part lab the down surface. We will be calling it as bed, the moving part. Okay, then we'll see the PPT. 1 minute. Stereolithography. Stereolithography is nothing but light is used and the resin. This used wire filament like structure, but in stereolithography, it is called SLA printers. Okay, it is called SLA printers. You can Google it up and you can see that SLA printers will be using some resin. Resin means it will be liquid like structure and it will be building up parts in a opposite manner, upside down manner, and the liquid will be treated up with laser, the UV light. That is called lithography. Litho means light. Okay, stereolithography is nothing but you are using light to get printed. Okay, so only we are talking about stereolithography. In the three process la, sintering first process is for metal printing. Metal, the next thing also they can print is using metal, but it's mainly focused on plastic materials. Stereolithography, it's for resin, liquid like filament, liquid like structure is converted into objects, 3D objects. These three technologies only they are using in different manners and different process to make many kinds of printers. You can name the other printers. You can see here binder jetting, direct energy deposition, material extrusion, material jetting, powder bed fusion, sheet lamination, vat polymerization. Okay, likewise, these are the 7 types of printers according to the process. This use mainly the 3 technology which we have explained at the beginning. These are the 7 types of printers using that 3 technology, but the different process of handling the items. It is differentiated into 7 types. These are the main types. Many types have been come right also according to the process, but this 7 types mainly comes. Okay. Can you ever have a doubt that only one color can be printed in using a 3D printer? How many of you guys have been having this doubt? Anyone has this doubt?
So multicolor also can be printed, no sir?
Yes, multicolor printers also right now available, but that is very much costly and it is very much brittle. Okay, if you want the printer to be printing it in color, it is very much costlier printer to purchase. It will be coming around 30 lakhs, 30 to 35 lakhs. It's come from company HP. HP inkjet printers, you have seen la? The normal printing. Normal Xerox shop or a Xerox machine, HP printers are there, right? That company has developed and many other companies like HP has developed this binder technology, which is for colored printers also. We'll look into the printers type. Okay, this is a binder binder jetting process. This, using this process, they have made this material. That is a metal. This is not plastic and all. This is a usual metal. Using this technology, they have built one binding jetting, and they have used material printing. They have printed this object. Okay, can you see how much precise it has been? For you, without 3D printers, you have to make one this kind of structure, means you have to spend some about lakhs, okay, around 5 to 10 lakhs you have to spend, some dyeing and so much of machining works will be there in 3D without 3D printers. But 3D printer has minimized our job, minimized the processing of things. But this is very much costly also. Nowadays 3D metal printing, it's very much costly. The machine is costing you around above 1 crore. The machine is costing 1 crore and above. But they can, it involves so many processes also. But any complicated shapes also we can do it. Can you imagine any complicated shapes? This is an engine bore. For that, we'll be using so much of manpower and so much of machinery works. So much of machines will be involved in to do this kind of a job in a normal thing. In a normal normal process, we are going to build this job, means it will be takes huge amount of manpower and the machineries to get this much sophisticated, this much engineered part to be coming out of a process. But this single machinery 3D printer has developed this kind of stuff, but it takes some time. But the use of manpower will be reduced drastically. It doesn't need more manpower. It needs only you have to develop one file and you have to feed it to your system, and some 3 to 4 processes are there. After post-processing, there will be 3 to 4 processes in binder jetting. Okay, this is like robotic arm. You have seen, right? You have seen some robotic arm, la. It will be layer by layer. It will be welding it. Okay, like I showed, la. We'll run the machine in the third day also. Before that, we'll see some usual things to be known to handle a 3D printer. Okay, next. Direct deposition, energy deposition, means it will be using electric beam or laser. Okay, electric beam or laser or an arc. It will be doing some directly. They will be welding the items above and above. If you have seen welding process, right? You have seen welding process, huh?
Yes, anywhere.
It will be putting one layer, la. It will be adding some item, their thickness. The welding arc welding you have seen, right? It will be adding some material to join two material. It will be adding some material, right or wrong?
Right.
So adding material on the above of each thing, layer by layer, what it will be happening, it will get bigger and bigger. Likewise,
yes,
they are printing an object using this kind of process. They are building 3D printed objects using this kind of process. Okay, direct energy deposition. This is what we have seen in the I have showed you in the camera, with this printers only we are having. So we have seen that this is material extrusion, that is melting process is involved. You can have two color printers also right now available. Using extruder, we can use two filament also extrude at a time, and they can build objects. Okay. Next, this is material jetting. It's like powder, like resin they'll be using. This and all comes under multicolor. We have seen, right? This this will be ejecting UV light, and printing litho stereolithography. We have seen, right? This is called that and all comes under this kind of printing. Bed fusion technology. This all this same process, but CO2 laser will be there and powders will be there. We'll talk more about this kind of printers later on as things go by. We'll talk more about this and I'll show some videos also. Okay. This sheet lamination, they'll be using some laser to cut the sheet in a particular layer by layer. You can see at the bottom, they have a huge kind of layers available here. Sheets of material, layer by layer, they will be cutting the sheets and it will be fused with one another. So it will be coming it in a single shape. This is called sheet lamination process. Sheet lamination process involved in this. Okay. Vat polymerization, this is called resin type printers. SLA printers, they will be calling it as stereolithography printers. Okay. This will be printed using liquid. This printers are pretty much costlier compared to the FDM printers. FDM printers are cost effective compared to this kind of comparing to all the printers, FDM printers are cost effective, but this is the next level of printing, SLA printing, that is resin printers. This will be having high accuracy and the surface finish, it will be very good. The surface finish from an SLA printer, that is resin printers, will be in high quality than an FDM printers. You can notice that there are layers. You can see some layer like structure here. I'll show in the camera. Can you all see the camera? Can you all see there is layers? I don't know how much you can see the layers. Okay, here also you can see. In this print, you can see a layer. Layer some
yes, sir.
Some kind of burr and all is there. Some kind of burr is there and layer by layer it is seen there. And some at the top also printing has been little much not to the expectation, right? This and all, it will be avoided in SLA printers. This won't be coming in FDM printers also. The infill amount of infill we give, according to that, it will be making this kind of damage and all. Can you see? This and all slightly damaged piece. Damage means printing has been not up to the mark. Which will be covering up it in the post processing. We'll rub it with the sandpaper and we'll put some paste and all here, and we'll make it into a nice product. After that, you'll be seeing like this. Okay. After that, you'll be seeing like this product. It will be very much finished. The post-processing works will be there in 3D printers. But the thing is that you can do any number of shapes or any kind of complicated shapes can be done using 3D printers. This is all about the types and this thing. Types of 3D printers and about 3D printers. If you have any doubts, means you can ask me now. Next we'll go some for we'll Google it up in some printers and we'll see what and all printers right now available so that you can understand a little more. If any doubts, means you can ask me now. Any doubts are there, students? Any doubts are there?
No, sir.
No doubts. Okay, I'll show you the this thing. How the 3D file will be looking, STL files. Okay, so that you will understand more. Can you all see the my screen?
Yes, sir.
Sure.
show you some STL files so that you can understand more. This Colido, we are using a Colido machine, ma, so that it's seen like this. Okay, this is a software. Can you all see? Can you all see the software?
Yes, sir. Yes.
This square type structure which you are seeing right now, it's the bed size of the printer which I am using. There are many icons right here. File menu is there. For loading and view, type of view we want, the front view or the isometric view. Okay, like that views we can change it over, and we can spot it. We can change it with your mouse also. We can scale it up. Wait, I'll scale it up and I'll show it to you so that you can understand a lot. We can turn it around also, ma. I'll first turn it around. Okay, and then we'll scale it up. I'm scaling it up to maximum level. Can you see the object?
Yes, sir. Yes.
This is the object which you are thinking to print. So what you will do, first thing, we have to load the object. Object placement is there. La? We have to load the object, and there is one icon there, add object like this string. Okay. If you want to click it from here, and you can add another object also. You can build at the same time 2 to 3 objects also we can build, ma. Okay. I'm taking in another object also. Okay, then I'm double clicking this, then I'm rotating this also, right? I have placed this and I have rotated this, and I have to do slicing. This is in STL file format, okay, but the printer can't understand this STL file. Can you understand? The printers can't understand the STL file. For the printer to understand this file, what and all we have to do, we have to see that here one slicer like icon is there. We have to click here, slice with Cura engine, right? It will be converting this STL file format into G code. Have you come across this G code? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Machine understandable coding, ma. This is nothing but we are giving commands to the server. This motors, la? What
is
that motor? Stepper motor. Yes. Thank you, ma. Thank you. The stepper motors. We are going to give some commands for the stepper motors. Okay. For that, we are going to convert the STL file format to G code. Right, we have now started the conversion process. It's been loading up, it's been converted. It's going on, it's loading up, and its conversion process is going on right now. Now it's been converted. It is written printing statistics, right? Can you all see that? Can you all see the printed timing? Sir. Estimated printing timing, 12 hours, 16 minutes, 16 seconds. Okay. This is an estimated time for this printing to happen. It will be taking around 12 hours. 12 hours means it will take around 15 hours also. It is not that it will take exactly the same amount of time. There is speed also right here. Can you see? Above from that, what structure you have given, there are structures at the bottoms. Can you all see? This structure and all we have given. This at the bottom, some structures have been, it has created some structures. Can you all see this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Why it is created? Can you all guess?
Supporting the...
Yes. The 3D printed object while printing, this already comes from a melted point of time, melting thing. While building the layer, what will we be doing? If we're going to be putting the layer or adding up the layer in a free space, the melted part will be it will be down to the surface, not the print will be not to the exact point. So what it does, some support structures, this software itself creates for the printer to print the correct component. In the slicer itself, there is an option right here. Can you note here, print settings, printer configuration, Polido, and adhesive type, raft. Raft brim is there, we will select raft because you can see at the bottom, in the printer preview, you can see at the bottom, the extra layer has come here, right? Extra layer has come for the usual material. Can you see, I'll show you in the real-time structure what we have built. Can you see this? This is a component which we have built, but there is one extra layer which has come right here. Can you all see this? One extra layer has come.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Can you all see that? One yes, extra sir. Layer. This is called brim and raft. Okay. Okay, wow. Then what we'll do, we'll share the screen and I'll show it again, the layer by layer thing. Okay, this raft also you have seen. Then again in the slicer, there is quality. Quality of the printing is 0.15, 0.2 and 0.3 is there. But this is the amount of thickness of the layer, thickness of the extruder filament which we have to print it. Okay, if the layer size is going to be 0.15 mm, lesser the size, the higher is the resolution. This is the resolution part. With this we can determine what kind of resolution we can put it on, what kind of resolution we have to build up. Okay, right here we can decide. As the resolution is higher, the amount of quality, quality means the resolution is 0.15 mm, the nozzle extruder filament size. This is nozzle extruder filament size, okay. Then the support type is, I have given everywhere. Okay, you can see in this, I'll show you again in the camera. You can see this stuff right here. You can see for arm and all, there are structures at the bottom. Can you all see this? Can you all see this, ma? There are structures.
Yes, sir.
This and all supporting. Because without this structure, we are going to print it. It will getting fall down. It will fall down from the, this hand won't be printed like this. It gets fall down and the printing will be horrible. The printing will be not nice. Okay, we can use flexible printing also. We can, there is a filament called TPU. TPU means it is a flexible filament which will allow the object to be flexible. Flexible is available. Okay, like rubber-like structure. then we'll see here. Then after slicing, like you can see here, then we can show layer by layer. Okay, you can see here how it will be printed layer by layer. Can you all see here? The printing process will be
sir the raft sir
yes, hello yes ma tell ma
the raft is within the structure or adding a new
adding
layer,
a new layer.
So
adding
how can we how can we remove it after
drying? Yes, we can remove it without raft also we can print ma. For removal from the bed alone we are giving raft and all. Okay, you can see layer by layer printing, right? Can you all see here?
Yes,
I'll change the layer. How much layers is there means you can see here the step by step printing process. Like this only it will be getting printed. Can you all see? Last it will be, it will come up with the last layer. Okay, step by step the layers will be printing out. Can you all see here, right here? Then after that we'll be going for manual control. This is a panel which will be having, we'll be having for this thing, the printer. When the printer is getting connected, this panel will be there and we can operate through this panel and control the things to be happening here. The feed rate and all is there, right? Fan is there and bed temperature will be there and the extruder type, how much temperature it has to be. We can change this extruder temperature, that's the nozzle temperature, in order to how much heating things will be there. For ABS filament, the heating temperature is different from the PLA filament. Can you understand? PLA filament is there and ABS filament is there, nylon filament is there. For each and every filament, the heat temperature for heating temperature will be, extruded temperature will be differing for each and every filament. So we'll be using that. Anyone understand that? Any doubts are there? That's all for today's session, ma. Right now, tomorrow we'll be having the scanning session. Scan. We'll do the scanning process and we'll edit that software and how it will be done. That and all we'll show how we are scanning and how we are scanning our own face. How we are scanning and person's face and all we'll show to you and how it will be happening and all we can learn tomorrow also. Any doubts Mr. means you can ask. As days go by we can see some videos also about the next level printers. Any doubts till now?
Students please give your feedback so that it will be very much easier for SAR to interact with you.
Yes.
Is it interesting? Is the session interesting for all of you?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay, you can tell if you want to know anything else about 3D printing, you can ask sir, so that he will share you in the forthcoming sessions. If anything particularly you want to ask.
One more thing, you can access internet. And you can find files for free also. Yeah, if you don't know how to design and all, some files will be free in the online. Okay, from Clamp will be there. N number of websites are offering free kind of things so that you can learn more. Right. Days go by, we learn much more things to operate and how many. How much things to be learned and all we can see there. I'll show one more thing. The websites and all I'll show you so that you can learn. Can you all see my screen?
Yes, sir.
There's a website called Thinkiverse, Ma. Thinkiverse. Do you know Thinkiverse website?
Yes, sir.
Yes. This is a pretty much free website so that you can download n number of things, n number of 3D printed objects, n number of 3D files, whatever files you need, you can download from here. Whatever you are going to search, it will be there for you. You can do lithography also. Lithographic photo frames also are available for different kinds of things. If you are going to upload your photo means, it will be giving you a litho pan. Litho pan, it will be, your face will be printed like, I'll show one other thing. 1 minute, I'm searching for that object. Yes, 1 minute. This is a website, like this, n number of websites are there. I'll show you one litho pan, okay? 1 minute. Can you all see the green plate? Can you all see, Ma?
Yes, sir.
Yes. This is a litho pan. Okay. What is this?
Litho.
How it operates, la? It's quite interesting to see here. I'll show in the sunlight itself. Can you all see that Abdul Kalam face?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is called litho pan. When you light it up at the background, it will be like a black and white photo. This is called litho pan. Okay, without light means it will be some embossed like structure, it will be seen. When you see under light, it will be seen like this. It will be completely you can see your face or any face which is litho pan, made into litho pan. I'm not able to handle it. Okay, sorry for the not handling this. This kind of structures are there. You can do a number of things. You can do a photo. This and all litho pan, it will be coming here. Litho pan. And it will be having various types of things also for you. Okay. Any doubts if you are having means, can ask me now. Yes. Any doubts, Ma?
No, sir.
No doubts. All clear, huh? Any doubts or you have any idea?
Sir, this Colido and all are free free software, sir.
If you buy the machine, means there will be free software, Ma. They will be giving you the software with the machine itself. That's not an issue. Any other doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Subramani, sir, for your wonderful session. And hope
you,
the students would have got some idea about the 3D printers and its necessity in the future. So, dear participants, with this we come to the conclusion of day one session. Tomorrow we'll be meeting with you with another interesting topic about the introduction to 3D scanner and the demo of 3D scanner. So meet you all tomorrow. I have posted the feedback link for day one. So the participants are requested to fill the form and leave.
Thank you, Subraman sir. Today's session is nice.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Recorded.